Students, today we will study noun. First of all, we will learn the definition of noun. That what is a noun? Look at the definition, children, given here. Nouns are naming words used to refer people, places, animals, or things. Now we will move to kinds of noun. Okay, so you can see that this banyan tree, this huge banyan tree, and here we have the kinds of noun. First of all, there is a common noun. What is a common noun? Any naming word in general. Okay, any city, town, village, boy, girl, these are common noun. And what is a proper noun? Any particular name of a river, for example Ganga, of a city, for example Jaipur, these are proper noun. And what is a material noun? For example, silk, wool, gold, silver, these are material noun. Now we move to collective noun. What is a collective noun, students? A group. A collective noun refers to a group. For example, a herd of cattle, swarm of bees, a library of books, a team of players, and a colony of ants. So these are collective noun. Now we move to abstract noun. What is an abstract noun? Students, that we can't see or touch and we can only feel that. For example, friendship, anger, jealousy, kindness. So these are the feelings that neither we can see, neither we can touch, and we can only feel it. So they are abstract. And what is a concrete noun? A concrete noun is that we can see, touch, or feel. For example, cat, table, book, pencil, these are concrete nouns. Now coming to uncountable nouns. For example, stars, rice, these are uncountable. As the name refers, that can't be counted, that is uncountable noun. And now coming to the last, that is a countable noun. So as the name refers, what is a countable noun? Boys, girls, mangoes, apples, bananas, these are countable nouns. Now students, look at this exercise. Underline the nouns in the following sentences. Okay, you have to identify the nouns and underline. Look at the first sentence A. The sun provides light and heat to humans, plants, and animals. So the naming words are sun, humans, plants, and animals. These are the nouns in this sentence. Look at B. Tanya plays badminton in that park with Sumit. Here, Tanya, it is a proper noun. Badminton, it is a name of a particular game. It is also proper noun. Park, that is a place. And Sumit. Sumit here is a proper noun. Okay, come to see. The organizers gave a bouquet of flowers to the chief guest. Okay, here the organizers. It is a collective noun, bouquet. It is also a collective noun. Okay, to the chief guest. Chief guest is a proper noun. Now come to D. Smile wants to make a kitchen garden in the backyard. Smile. Smile is a proper noun. Okay. Now come to E. The utensil. Utensil, it is a common noun. It's made of aluminium. Aluminium is a material noun. And silver. Silver too is a material. Now, look at sentence F. Mahatma Gandhi propagated the ideas of peace and non-violence through his philosophy. Here, Mahatma Gandhi is a proper noun. Okay? Ideas of peace. Peace is an abstract noun. As I have already taught that we can't see, touch, we can only feel. Okay, that is abstract noun. Non-violence, that is two abstract nouns. And philosophy. Philosophy is a proper noun. Okay, coming to G. The doctor said, doctor is a
common that sprouts help in improving digestion. Here doctor and sprouts are nouns, common nouns. S, determination along with patience and confidence leads to success. Now here determination, patience, confidence, these are abstract nouns. Okay, because we can neither see them or touch them, we can only feel them. Now students, look at this exercise. Write A for abstract noun and CR for concrete noun. Okay, so look at the first sentence. Madhubala was famous for her beauty. Here Madhubala is concrete noun and beauty is abstract. Okay, so CR for concrete noun and A for abstract. Now come to B. Milk and fruits are essential for healthy lifestyle. Milk is a concrete noun, or you can say it is a material noun also. And fruits, this is also concrete noun. And healthy, this is abstract noun. Okay? So within bracket, CR for concrete and A for abstract. Now come to C. Most living organisms float in the Dead Sea. Okay, living organisms, they are concrete noun and dead, that is abstract noun. So CR for concrete and A for abstract. Okay, now come to D. Drinking green tea helps in reducing stress. Okay, green tea, that is concrete noun, and stress, that is abstract. So you can write CR for concrete noun and A for abstract. Now look at E. He had to take his dog to the vet for vaccination. Here dog, vet, okay, both are concrete. Now come to F. The dentist recommended a special toothpaste to help relieve my tooth sensitivity. Here, dentist, toothpaste are concrete now and relieve my tooth sensitivity. Relieve and sensitivity. This is abstract noun because it is a feeling. Relief is a feeling. Okay? So, dentist and toothpaste, they are concrete noun. Two concrete noun. Okay? And relief and sensitivity are abstract. Okay? Now come to the last sentence. G. All green plants prepare their own food through photosynthesis. Here, green plants, that is concrete noun. And photosynthesis, this is a process through which plants make their food from sunlight. So, it is abstract noun. So, green plants, concrete noun. And photosynthesis, abstract. Now look at this exercise. Bracket the countable nouns that can be counted. This is a countable noun. And underline the uncountable nouns in the following sentences. So children, you also know what is uncountable noun. For example, stars, rice, milk, these are uncountable nouns. So have a look at the first sentence. A. He needed some glue to fix the vase. Here vase is a countable noun. So it is within bracket and glue is uncountable, so it has to be underlined. B. There is enough petrol for the car to reach home. Here, car and home, both are countable nouns, so they are within bracket. and petrol is uncountable. So it is underlined here. Now go to C. My daughter loves listening to country music. Here daughter is within bracket because it is a countable noun and music is uncountable, so it has been underlined. Now come to D. They order fried rice and curry from the restaurant. Okay, rice and curry. These are uncountable nouns, so they are underlined. And restaurant is a countable noun, so it is within bracket. Now come to E. Varuni is playing with a ball on the seashore with her friends. Here Varuni, ball and friends, all three are countable nouns, so they are within bracket. Now come to F. I would like to have sandwich and some cookies. Here sandwich and cookies, both are countable, so they are within bracket. Now look at G. The student showed a remarkable improvement in the last examination. Okay, students, that is within bracket as it is a countable noun. Now come to H. The residents have decided to get rid of the rubbish lying on the road. Here residents, that is countable noun, so it is within bracket, and rubbish, that is uncountable noun, so it is under. Now students, look at this exercise. Fill in the blanks with correct option. You have to complete these sentences with nouns. Okay, now have a look at the first sentence. A. The dash of drawers. The chest of drawers. Here it is a collective noun for drawers. B. Dash was built on a dash of seven islands. Mumbai. Mumbai is a proper noun. Was built on a troop of seven islands. It is a collective or a group name. C. I like dash more than dash. I like biology more than mathematics. D. Dash always speaks the dash. Prashant. Prashant is the proper noun. Always speaks the truth. Truth is the abstract noun that we can't see or touch. That is an abstract noun. E. Mr. Khanna congratulated all the dancers in the group for their wonderful performance. F. Dash was filled with dash when she won the dash. Tisha here is a proper noun. Was filled with joy. Joy is an abstract noun. When she won the competition. G. The dash was built by dash. The Vijay is now. It is a fort in Rajasthan, was built by Rana Kumha. It is again a proper noun. Was built to celebrate his victory over Manu Khilji. Now students, look at this exercise. Complete the following sentences with abstract noun. Here you are given options in the bracket, and with the help of these options you have to complete the sentences. And what is an abstract noun? An abstract noun is that noun that we can't see, touch, we can only feel it. Like anger, love, jealousy, kindness. These are examples of abstract noun. Now have a look at this sentence. B. I will inform you if there is any dash in our company. Okay? If there is any vacancy. Second. she wants to do each and every task with perfection. Here perfect is given in the bracket. D. Never judge a person by his or her appearance. E. They shall be punished for their bad dash towards others, for their bad behavior. Behavior towards others. F. Complete the following dash within 10 minutes. Activity. Within 10 minutes. G. The dash of his painting won him the dash. The uniqueness. Uniqueness is an abstract noun. The uniqueness of his painting won him the competition. H. Rima got a dash for academic dash. For a Rima got a scholarship. Rima got a scholarship. Rima got a scholarship. For academic excellence. Now students, identify the errors and rewrite the following sentences correctly. You have to identify the errors in the sentences and again you have to rewrite the sentence in correct. Okay? So B. Gleeful is next to godliness. As you already know this a famous proverb. So what is the error? Gleeful. This is the error in the sentence. It should be cleanliness. Cleanliness is next to godliness. As we all know. Next. Farhan is determined to get a good education. Here it is the error in the sentence. Now, rewrite the sentence. Farhan is determined to get a good education. To get a good education. Parul is the unseen of our school. Here, Parul and Ansi. These are the two errors in the sentence. Because whenever we write a proper noun, it should start with a capital. Parul is the Ansi of our school. An army of singers marched towards the battlefield. Okay? Army. Army is a collective noun for ants. But here in the sentence it is for singers. So this is the error. Okay. A choir of singers. Choir is the collective noun for singers. A choir of singers march towards the battlefield. Towards the battlefield. Battlefield. Now students, look at sentence F. Shikha is known for her intelligence. The error in the sentence. So you have to correct this error. Shikha is known for her intelligence. that magician uses a packet of cards to show magic tricks. That magician uses a pack of cards. A pack of cards to show magic tricks. Pawn came with a gang of dancers to perform at the wedding celebration. Gang is a collective noun for robbers, jackers. It is not for dancers. So the correct choice or answer will be Pawan came with a group of dancers. Group is a collective name for dancers to perform at the wedding celebration.